to week, and comes back again from week to Inverness. Of the trials and the troubles of a Scottish railway gear, the British public really can't guess. When the old express goes dashing off at 14 miles an hour, and the heather hills go slowly gliding past, it stops at every station, then we start it up again, as the gears upon the whistle gets the blast. Och, and I'm in my glory in the old gear's van, sitting at my ease upon the sewer dip can. Sometimes quick, sometimes slow, a wiggle and a tinkle and the way we go. When the old express leaves Inverness, the people gather round, and they start us on our journey with a cheer. Aye, and on a day excursion, they always stay for trumps, in case we are away for half a year. Then I fasten up the carriage doors and tie them up with string. I blow my whistle, then I wave my flag. But one day I forgot my flag, it was a lucky thing that I had ginger whiskers I could wag. Oh, but I'm in my glory in the old gear's van, sitting at my ease upon the sewer dip can. Sometimes quick, methodically slow, a wiggle and a tinkle and away we go.
Of course, Mingy, I haven't always been the guard. Oh, no. I got this by sheer merit and perseverance. I started in a small way. First I was a porter. That's when I had to work. I was up at 5 o'clock in the morning polishing up the milk cans. Then I got my sandpaper out and polished the lines in 2 miles each direction. I always keep the station nice and clean. Ah, well, there's not a soul about. Not a solitary soul on the station, deserted. I might as well move on to the next station. I might get a customer there. So once more, on duty, I'll wave my flag. Goodbye. All on board, please. But not a soul.
Sitting at my ease upon the sewer dip can. Sometimes quick, methodically